In this video, we're going to be creating a spinning organization tray. These trays can be mounted on a pipe so they can spin, and they can also stack for a ton of storage. These are great for screws and nuts, hardware, or art supplies, and these are great for keeping small parts separated and easy to find. The skills we're going to be learning in this video are going to be the Revolve tool, offsets, patterning, Boolean combines, and of course, some extrudes and fillets. So let me go ahead and show you what the model looks like over here. You can see I've got three of these things. They are patterned across here, and if I spin these around here, I can see you can see exactly how they kind of stack up here, and you can spin these around, and you've got a whole bunch of different individual little bins here. Each one has eight little bins, so of course you can store quite a bit of supplies in these things and easily have access to each layer there, and in each individual layer will actually spin separately, so it's pretty handy, nice little thing to have. So let's jump in and see how we create something like this. So I'm going to head up here to File, and I'm going to say a new project. And right over here, because I'm going to be revolving this around, I'm just going to create one little section of it. And I'm going to start a sketch right over here, and I'm going to choose something like this plane right over here. And notice I'm here on the right plane, and let's go ahead and just start with the line command. Notice it's already activated. Now, I don't want to start at the origin because obviously we want to have a hole in this thing, right? So I want to start a little distance away from that. I'm going to move up here, and I'm going to type in 50 millimeters because I know that is the height of that center hub that I want. And I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and then zoom out here a little bit so I can see exactly what's going on. I'm going to snap that right there. Okay, then I'm going to move over. Now, I've kind of predefined this a little bit, so it makes it a little bit easier for us to figure out what's going on. So I'm going to type in 15 right there, 15 down, and come over here, and I'm going to make sure we snap that to the horizontal. This one here, I'm just going to snap down here. I'm not going to put a dimension quite yet. Come over here. Let's add an angle to this thing, and then bring it all the way back to the original starting point there. Now, we've added a few dimensions, but we want to add a few more to kind of define the shape of this thing. So I'm going to hold down, turn off the line command by hitting escape. I'm going to hold this, click on this bottom line here, hold down shift on my keyboard. I'm going to select these two lines here. I'm going to type in that value there. So I want 120. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that one and type in 125, actually. 125, there it is. Oh, actually, you do actually have to hit enter. So let's try that one more time. So here, hit over here, click over there, 125, hit enter, and there it is. My height, I'm gonna click on this line right here, hold down shift, and select that guy down there. And as far as this dimension here, that wants to be 35. So 35 right there, boom, that moves over there. And then the point, that point right there, over here to the center line. Notice, where is our center line? So here's our center line right here. So I'm going to hold down shift and select that center line. And this value here wants to be 125. Boom. The last thing we need to define is the center hole. So I'm going to choose this line here. Hold down shift, choose the center line. And notice it happens to be 5 millimeters right now. I actually want it to be 16.891. So click on that one there. So I'm going to click on that and say 16.891, and that happens to be the perfect size to fit on a 1-inch piece of pipe. So I calculated that out, or figured that out earlier, so we now know exactly what that dimension is. Again, if you don't hit enter, it actually does not work, believe it or not. So let's try that one more time. And here it is 16.891. Hit enter this time, and there it is. It moves right over there, and everything's looking pretty solid. Okay, so that is the shape that I want to revolve around. Okay, and I'm going to hit revolve on the keyboard. So if I just hit anywhere else out of here, of course, I can slide things around a little bit here, but I'm going to hit R on the keyboard for, no, I'm not. What am I doing here? Let's go back. All right, so move this back to the center of the screen here. So now we are no longer going to be, we're going to exit sketching. So now we're not in that anymore. And we're going to go down here to tools, and we're going to go and do a revolve. So revolve happens to be V. It would make sense if it was R, but R for rectangle also kind of makes sense. So we're going to go ahead and choose revolve right over here. And it's first thing it's going to ask is, hey, what do we want to revolve around? I want to revolve that thing right there. And what is the axis that I want to revolve around? I'm going to choose that center axis right there. And right that easily, I already have my shape, and it's looking pretty good. The only problem is I don't want to go all the way around, right? Notice right here it says 360. If I click right there, I can type in something like 45. right? 45 degrees. That's going to give me a one piece of the pie. I want eight individual bins, and 45 degrees is going to give me exactly what I'm looking for. So go ahead and click on the checkbox. There it is. And now I've got that shape. So right over here, here's my items. I'm going to go ahead and hide that sketch. So now I'm just looking at that one there. And we got a couple things we probably want to do at this point. Number one is we want to add a little radius to the bottom. So I'm going to click on this, spin it around. I'm going to click on that edge right there, and I'm going to drag out that fillet, right? So I'm going to type in something like 30, and that gives us a nice little fillet at the bottom, looking pretty good. And now we want to do a shell, right? We want to shell this thing out so it's all hollowed out. So I'm going to go ahead and come over here to some different tools. And one of those happens to be shell. So right over here, it's also H on your keyboard. Click on shell. I'm going to choose that top surface. I want to get rid of that. I'm going to type in 3 millimeters is the thickness of the shell that I want. Click OK. And now I've shelled that out. So now I have this nice little bin. Everything's looking pretty good, right? So it's pretty good so far, you know. But if I was going to like 3D print this thing or mold this thing, you're probably going to have a problem with this kind of like hollow section, because it's hollow inside of here now. And if you can't see that, I can go over here and choose the appearance and show hidden edges, and that will allow us to kind of see in there a little bit. You can see that this is actually kind of hollowed out inside there, and that may be a problem for us. We also want some extra strength in this area, because that's kind of going to be the hub. This thing could be kind of heavy, so we want to kind of fill that area in. So let's go ahead and turn that back off. So I'm going to go to appearance and show hidden edges, turn that off. Now what I want to do is I want to create a shape like this one right here. I want to like drag it up, right? I want to go up. If you go down, notice it goes the wrong direction. So we're going to be creating a new shape. Click OK, and then leave that shape. So now here's my face offset. But that's really not what I want to do. I don't want to offset the face. I actually want to create a new extrusion. But instead of going up, I want to go down. So that's not what I want to do. Let's go ahead, right click, and hit delete. This time I'm going to choose this one here. I'm going to say, hey, I want to create a sketch, right? That's that sketch I want to work on right here. And then I want to hit E for extrude. So now what I want to do is I want to take this value here, this body, I want to move it down. I want to extrude it. So because I'm going down this way, notice something weird happens. I'm going to go up first, right? And click OK. So I've created this thing by going up, and now I've got this new extrusion right over here that's adding this piece here. But in reality, I want to go down, but because the way the software is working is it thinks I'm going to try to subtract things if I go down. So I want to go up first, but then I want to go over here to the history bar. Click on this over here, and I want to say, hey, I want to go a distance, right? But instead of a typed in distance, I want to say up to an object. And I say, hey, I want to actually go down here to this bottom, right? So that's what I want to go down to. So if I go over here, I want to say, hey, I want to do a up to object. And I want to choose up the object. I'm going to fix that thing. I'm going to choose the object. Okay, click on done. So now it's going to bring that face and bring it all the way down to the bottom. That kind of solves the problem, right? First we had to go up, then we got to go down. It's a little bit of workaround, but it allows us to quickly create the shape and then use that history bar to modify the shape so it does exactly what we're looking for. Okay, now I've got that shape. It's looking pretty good. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to spin this thing around. Now, remember I told you I wanted to have this kind of uniform wall thickness of 3 millimeters everywhere. So right now this top surface here, or you know, the front is 3 millimeters, the bottom is 3 millimeters. This is a thicker section here, but we could hollow that out from the bottom or something like that if you're going to mold it or something like that. But I do want that to be a thicker section, so I want to keep that one separate. But what about when I spin this thing around, because these sidewalls both happen to be 3 millimeters, when I pattern it, those are actually going to end up being 6 millimeters because I'm going to be doubling up the walls. So what I want to do is I actually want to thin out those walls now before we spin them around. So I'm just going to choose this wall here. I'm just going to move this over a little bit. And if I move it too far, it just kind of gets rid of it. I'm going to type in 1.5 is the distance I want to move it over. And then I want to do the exact same thing over here. I want to grab that guy here and just kind of slide it right over just a little bit. Hold on. 1.5 millimeters, which is happens to be half the thickness. Now notice that wall and that wall are pretty thin. But you'll see when we spin this thing around that it makes everything a 3 millimeter wall thickness. Okay, now you can guess the next thing we're going to do is a revolve. So our friend over here, if we click on some of the different tools we have, and we have this thing called a, well, actually, we're not doing a revolve. We're actually going to be doing a pattern, right? It's a revolved pattern. And so we actually need to be over here, and here's our pattern. Click on pattern. We have a couple of options. We have a linear pattern or a circular pattern. Click on circular. right? And it's asking us for what are the bodies, right? So which body? I want to use that body, and then I want to revolve around something, right? So it's asking what I want to revolve around. Well, I need to use this little point here. I want to drag this over here to the origin, right? And then I want to spin this thing around. Notice if I spin it around, notice what I get. I get all these different options here. So it's asking me, hey, what's this angle here? So I'm going to say 360. I want to go all the way around, plus or minus, doesn't really matter. And how many, right? I want 8 of them, right? Because I want this thing to be fully filled up, right? And then that's looking pretty good, right? So click on the green, or not the green checkbox, but blue checkbox. There it is. And there's my shape, right? Everything's looking pretty good. Now, notice we have a bunch of individual bodies. Here's all our different bodies right here. And of course, in this state here, you can hide and show these bodies and see what you've got going on here, which is pretty handy. But we really want to bring all these together. We want to make one part. Okay, so what we want to do is come down here to some tools. So we've got some tools down here, and one of them happens to be the Boolean union, right? So we want to click on union, click on this one here, and we want to bring these together. So Boolean is a, you can add things, you can subtract things, you can do a bunch of different things here. But if I choose this face here, that one there, and I'm just choose these bodies as we go around, it's going to be bringing these things together. Click OK, and now we have one individual part. Okay, so a couple more things we may want to do at this point. We might want to add a couple of fillets, things like that. So you've got a pretty sharp edge out here. If you look at that edge, I probably don't want to have that sharp edge here. So let's click on that edge itself, and the fillet, we want to just kind of bring in like, you know, something like that, like a little 1 millimeter fillet, which is fine. Same thing on this inside edge here. I can choose actually all those if I hold down shift and just kind of work around the shape here. Let's go zoom in a little bit, pick that edge. And sometimes you got to spin it around a little bit or zoom in if we want to get all those little edges. There's the last one right over there. And then my fillet, I can drag this little arrow here. And I think just like 1 millimeter is going to be fine for that. So 1 millimeter fillet inside and out, both looks pretty good. All right, so there is my fillet on the inside. Now, of course, you could fill it in here, you could fill it down here, you could fill around wherever you want. But right now, that's looking pretty solid. You know, looks like a pretty good shape. Now, of course, we want these to stack, and we want to kind of take a look at what that's going to look like, right? So we want to use another pattern. In this case, come down here again to some of the transform tools. Here's our pattern, but this same time, instead of doing a circular pattern, we actually want to switch, click on the little drop down here and click on to linear. Right, and it's going to ask us, what do we want to pattern? Well, I want to pattern that body, and I want to go up, right? And of course, you can define how many things you'd like to pattern, and I want to choose something like the front face so I can see exactly what's going on here. And you can see, okay, here's my pattern, of course, here's my 3x, here's my spacing, but you can just use the arrows and just kind of drag this thing up and down. You can see, like, right about there, wait, a little bit up, there it is. Okay, pretty good. Of course, get those things lined up so that's about what you're gonna look like, and then click OK, right? Now you can spin that around. You can say, hey, does that look pretty good? Like, can I get my fingers in here to get these components out? Do we need to add a little more spacing? What do we need to do? How many more of these things can I stack up? Figure out exactly how high this whole thing's gonna be when you get done. You know, adjust the sizing, adjust the filleting, a bunch of things. And you might say, hey, you know, instead of 8 little boxes, maybe I'd like to have 4, or maybe I just want 2, or maybe I want 16, you know. Whatever that angle is, doesn't matter. Of course, we can just do the exact same thing just by going back here in the history bar and taking a look at some of these revolves. My first little revolve has to be whatever that segment of the pie is going to be. If it's going to be 30 degrees or 45 degrees, maybe it's 90 degrees, I don't know, whatever it is, figure that out. And then, of course, it has to have a matching revolve or pattern that would make the, you know, full amount of pieces around. But a bunch of things you can do there. And then, of course, if you're happy with what you have, you want to see how it might look as far as, like, if you rendered it, you can switch over here to visualization. And we can drag and drop some different materials and things like that. So I can say, hey, I want to put ABS on the top here, or I want to come down here and apply some other colors. I want to say, you know, let's put black over here, maybe some blue over here. And now we've got a shape that looks like that. Looks pretty nice. And you can see how that would all come together. Of course, this would be great for 3D printing or just playing with. And if you're doing some hobbies, or you have a lot of little small parts like nuts and bolts and screws, This is a great way to keep them all organized. So hopefully this project has been informational for you, and hopefully maybe you can build a part like this and use it in your shop or in your workshop or in your crafting station, whatever happens to be your flavor of entertainment. Anyways, thanks for watching, and check back soon.